I can't explain. Peace that stills my soul. Light in the darkest place. Life, even in the pain, it feels like coming home. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. I am free, amen. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. I am free, amen. Here, I'm alive again. Gone is the weight of sin.
Great to see you guys. Thanks for coming by.
Thank you.
Man, these songs are so exciting and so fresh. And I think the thing I'm really drawn to with what you guys are creating, the songs that you're creating, is there's a little bit of this, you know, kind of a gospel-y influence in it, a little bit of a country thing there. And it's just all kind of fused into this really cool worship expression, which is amazing. Yeah, we hear a lot of around worship circles, it's like, man, like worship music is starting to sound all the same. This does not sound the same, and it's amazing. And this song is a great example of that, a song called Free Amen. But talk about the song. Maybe we'll start with you, Ed, and just like where some of these pieces and parts of the song came from and the ideas behind it.
Yeah, I think the way that songs unfold is so fascinating. You know, you never really know how they're going to go. So the bridge to this song was like the first component, and it was probably 3 or 4 years old. It was just something that I just, you know, it's based off of, I mean, a lot of people think of Martin Luther King's speech, you know, when he used the free at last, thank God Almighty I'm free at last, which actually comes from an old gospel spiritual. Mm. And I've always loved, you know, that. And I was just singing one day and just had a little melody down. And I honestly put it in my phone and sort of forgot about it. And then fast forward, like, you know, 3 or 4 years later, This chorus came, which is from 2 Corinthians, you know, and it's just one of those songs that it just, the chorus just says it over and over and over again. I need the reminder, you know. Sometimes I forget that I'm free in Christ and what that actually really means. So, yeah, the chorus just keeps saying, you know, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom, and I am free. Amen. You know, I love that declaration. And for us, we just started, I remember we had a moment with this song. We were in our church sanctuary by ourselves.
Laying on the stage.
What's that?
Laying on the stage, racking our brain about how to finish the song.
Yeah, yeah. But we were just caught up in the Spirit of God. And I remember just playing this together, and it was just, I just felt the spirit of worship in the room. It was a sweet moment. So we had the chorus, and I was like, oh my gosh, this chorus and this bridge, this, you know, they would go together. And then we had this other song. Martin had written a bridge for another song altogether that ended up becoming the verse for this song. And it was just so cool to see, how this, you know, we really want to, when we're writing songs, we really want them to come from an authentic, inspired place and not trying to strive and, you know, fit a round peg in a square hole. Because you can feel sometimes when it's trying to bump up, you know, and just, especially with worship songs, you just want, you know, you want the flow to be right. Martin, maybe it'd be a good time for you just to share a little bit about how this song is.
I've kind of told y'all, anytime I hear this song initially when it's like just me, and you kind of touched on it, but I have a really hard time believing that I'm free based on just like my track record and things that I do, you know, in a given day. It's like clearly, you know, I'm not free from this. I'm still struggling, and, you know, it kind of makes me upset. Just like, man, why can't I believe this for myself? But anytime we've been out, you know, on the road or in church and heard people sing this, you know, when I hear them sing it back to me, there's something that hits me like, man, if they can believe it, maybe I can too. So that's just what's hit me, you know, when I've heard this song, is that like corporate encouragement, you know, that I need. So it's been amazing.
Wow. And I love like that there's a declaration in the chorus. He says, I'm free. And then I love, and Ed had that lyric, adding the word amen to that. I just love it, man, because I think that it's really beautiful not to only declare the truth of Scripture and declare God's promises, but then to celebrate them. And to me, the amen is the celebration of this truth that, oh my goodness, because of the blood of Jesus, I'm totally free. And that's something, I mean, if we don't celebrate that, there's nothing to celebrate, you know, and it's amazing.
Yeah, and I love that it's that pure Scripture. In that course as well. I mean, you're putting in the mouth of your worshipers, like the Word of God.
Mm-hmm.
It's super powerful.
Mm.
Yeah. Mm. Well, Ed, walk us through what you're playing. You're capo 3?
Yeah, capo 3, C position. And the intro and the verse to this are kind of the same. Sometimes we'll do this little amen thing at the very beginning, just sort of like an intro kind of added thing, which is like C, 5/7, 6. 5/4, 1/3, 2. So again, amen, 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 like that. And that's the same chords as those are the same chords for the verse as well. Hope, 5/7, 6, da 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 da, 5/4. 1/3, 2, 2 minor. All those twos are two minors. And then the chorus is super simple. Where the Spirit of the Lord is. Just a little sus right there. I am free, amen. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. I am free, amen. I mean, even right now, just playing that, like, I feel my heart wanting to, like, I know this is being filmed or whatever, and, I'm thankful this is going out, but I just want to get lost in this, you know, in the spirit of worship right now. That chorus does that to me every time. The bridge, thank you, Scott. The chorus on the second time, so it does that sus thing for the first half, but for the second half, it actually goes to a four chord. Of the Lord is there is freedom. Ah, back to the one, and then back to the four, amen. Then to a six, where the Spirit of the Lord is. Four, there is freedom. And then a five, sus, I am free, amen. And then a five. Angie, you might have to help me on the numbers for this bridge. This bridge gets a little tricky. We're trying to give it some soul. And it goes free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, I am free at last. So in theory, it's pretty simple. It's just like just a one and then a four. And then walks down the second time to a five and then back to one. So I'll slow that down a little bit and play it. So it's like one, four, and then one, sus, one, six, five, one, and then four, and then walk down one, five over seven, six, five, sus, back to the one. Yeah.
Amazing. And you could do this just as you're talking about, you know, the spirit of worship, as you're playing just with a guitar, this song works.
Yeah.
In any setting.
Yeah.
That's what I love about it. Yeah. Thank you guys so much for coming by and sharing it with
us. Absolutely. Let me tell you, I'm free.